Hello everyone, today we will learn about means of transport. The vehicles that we use to travel from one place to another are known as means of transport. People travel from one place to another for different purposes. We go to school, to our workplace, to the market, to the hospital, to the post office for social gatherings like weddings, birthday parties, etc. To go on holiday trips, we use a bus, train or plane. These are all different means of transport. The story of transport. In ancient times, when there were no means of transport, people used to walk on foot from one place to another. Later on, they learned to use horses, mules, camels, and donkeys as means of transport. Gradually, when the wheel was invented, travel became easier, faster, and more comfortable. Carts were made, which was pulled by horses, mules, or ponies. Even now, horse carts and bullock carts carry people and goods in villages. To travel by water, they made rafts by tying together logs of woods. Much later, engines were invented. Travel became easier, faster, and more comfortable. Gradually, many vehicles such as scooters, cars, buses, trains, etc. came into operation. These new vehicles used fuels like petrol, diesel, and compressed natural gas, CNG. Means of transport. Different means of transport are required to carry both people and goods. The mode of transport that we use depends upon the place we live in. When we have to go for a short distance from home, we use a cycle, bike, or a car. If the place is very far from our home, we use a train or an aeroplane. The kind of transport we choose to travel in depends upon the distance to be traveled and the time we can spend to do it. In villages, people travel by bullock carts, tempos, and tongas. In deserts, people use camels and horses. Ponies, mules, and yaks are used to carry goods in mountains and hilly areas. Elephants are used in forests to carry heavy logs. Basically, there are three types of transport: land transport, water transport, and air transport. Land transport. All vehicles that move on land, like cars, rickshaws, cars, buses, trucks, and trains, are called means of land transport. People in our villages still travel on bullock carts and tractors, as many villages do not have proper roads. In hilly areas, people use animals such as donkeys, ponies, horses to travel and carry heavy loads. Sledges pulled by dogs are used in areas where there is heavy snowfall. If we have to visit our relatives or friends, go to work, go for shopping, we mostly use rickshaw, car, bus, auto rickshaw, etc. If we plan a trip to a nearby town, we use bus, car, and train. Trucks, cars, and trains run on land. These are used to carry people and goods. Land transport is the most common mode of transport used by us. In metropolitan cities like Delhi, Kolkata, Mumbai, and Chennai, metro trains run. Bangalore and Jaipur are other cities where metro trains run. Metro trains carry lakhs of people from one end of the city to another. It is very fast and comfortable mode of transport. Water transport. Water transport is the oldest and cheapest means of transport. Boats, ships, steamers, and rafts are means of water transport. Smaller boats such as yachts can sail on lakes and rivers. Water transport is slower than land and air transport. However, A large number of people or large quantities of goods can be transported by ships to far-off places. The Indian Navy patrols the coastline in highly mechanized ships. Boats and ships are made in shipyards. Air transport. Air transport is the fastest means of transport and also the most expensive. It is used to cover long distances in a short time. It helps us to reach far-off places in a few hours. We use aeroplanes and helicopters as means of air transport. They need an airport to take off and land. Most of the big cities in India have airports. Thank you. Bye-bye. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe our channel. Bye-bye.